It was a rainy day in my shop and I thought it would be nice to start the new year with a relaxing turning project. Making a captive ring goblet seemed perfect. So after making this rough prototype, I mounted another apricot piece on the lathe and started turning. The bark was the first thing to fly off. The roughing gouge worked nicely to turn the stock true. Next, to make a tenon for the chuck with the skew. Here I flatten one edge with the parting tool. I started hollowing with the bowl gouge, but that didn't seem to work that good. I had a lot of catches. Next, I tried the spindle gouge, but didn't have much luck either. Hollowing end grain is always a pain, and I think my tools were just too large for this job. So I made a hole to remove some material, and I grinded a small chisel as a scraper. And that worked out pretty nicely. At this point, I sanded the interior of my goblet. Next, I marked the ring's position so I wouldn't remove much material from this area. I then started shaping with a spindle gouge. At this point, I sanded the exterior of the ring and the rest of the goblet. To part the ring off, I used two small scrapers I made from Allen keys. First, you remove material from one side, and then you part the ring off from the other. I used wrench locking pliers to hold the scrapers while turning, and I took it really slow. After a while, the ring was free. You can guide the ring easily to spin to the side, so you can clean the leftover area. To sand the interior of the ring, you use the goblet as a spindle sander. Just add sandpaper and a zip tie. After 100 grit, move on to 220. I finished the goblet with Yorkshire grit abrasive paste. You applied the paste, slow down your lathe, and then using a paper towel, you polish your piece. Finally, I parted the piece off the lathe with a hacksaw. It came out pretty nice. It was a really fun project. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. But that was it. See you soon with a new project video.